Hello everyone, Cree here, bringing you back in the Camille top lane. I forgot my intro, not gonna lie. This is an actual ranked video, by the way. It's not a PBE video for once. So we are playing Camille in the top lane, and today we are against a Lulu. Now before I do go into runes, I'm currently going to Lulu. What I do want to say is the sponsor of today's video. Wow, that minion blocked me, so I didn't auto that minion. And the sponsor for today's video is, indeed, the like button. Now, it's a very, very recurring sponsor, and I don't know why they sponsored me, but regardless, it's a great sponsorship, and I appreciate them a lot. And so, you guys really should. If you don't know what the sponsor is, basically you scroll slightly down the video and you see it right there, the like button. It looks white or grayed out, but then once you click it, it turns blue, which is actually kind of crazy how far technology has evolved. So if you guys don't mind, hit the like button. It truly helps content creators that are small like me grow. And also, commenting also really puts us in the algorithm, so it'd mean a lot if you guys actually did that. But anyways, runes you're currently going are Grassy Undying, Shield Bass, Psycho Wind over Growth. Then we have Magical Footwear, plus Biscuit Delivery. So we are against a Lulu top, which I do find kind of strange. But they do have, she does have Corrupting Pot, which honestly, pretty broken to honestly lane against, if I'm being honest. Just 375 free HP and mana sustain is kind of ridiculous. I am hoping in Season 11, they actually remove that completely. Because I mean, it's just kind of not really fair. It's kind of like I have to all in. And if I don't all in, then it kind of sucks. She canceled my Q too, by the way, with that Polymorph. That's genuinely surprising. And she just popped her second Corrupting Pot, which is actually good for me. Like, basically, whenever you already get a Corrupting Pot person, you want to somehow get a really good trade to the point where you somehow make them use all their pots, or at least two of their pots in that one trade, and you only have to trade one pot or nothing at all. That's generally what you want to do. Or somehow, you know, make them run from all their mana sustain. Doesn't have to be HP sustain. Generally, just mana sustain alone is good enough. She started walking down. You can't really do that, man, because of Lucian. Cassiopeia's not there, so if she does happen to do this, then we're going to be in a bad spot. Q2. She doesn't polymorph me that time, which is very interesting. We are going to drop a ward. He actually stole it, by the way. Good job, Mr. Graves. That is what I like to see. Hits that. Try to find Echo. I appreciate that, buddy. But yeah. Lulu. Anti-fun. I mean, that's what I assume. I mean, I guess Lulu mid's probably the same thing. The thing is, I am a melee champ, but she's trying to harass me to her heart's content. And I actually have more farm than her, despite me being a, you know, she's harassing a melee champ, which is actually just pretty funny if I do say so myself. She does have biscuits, though, so the actual idea of her running is not really going to exist. But the entire rest of the team, they have Lucian mid as well, and then Leona, Ash bot. So their comp actually really sucks if they don't get a lead. But if they do happen to get a lead, well, they have Leona and Lulu to actually just skyrocket their carries, which is literally the only issue. Now, I do want to jump on this chick soon, but she's actually hugging the wall I use. Nice. There you go. Wow, I failed my auto Q2. For some reason, I just only Q2'd. All right, it's whatever. That's fine. I can probably look for a kill here shortly. There is Echo. Nice try, buddy. I'm surprised you're actually still around. I'd appreciate it if you actually just recalled for me, buddy. He's recalling now, but what I can do is I can walk over here into the bush after 8 seconds to see if he truly recalled or not. Which I'm not going to bother doing because this wave is going to crash under my turret. So we are just going to pick this up. No auto that. Nice. Let me unlock my screen. I should have unlocked that a lot sooner, honestly, but this is my first game of the day, so I'm just going to chalk it up to me being bad on my first games of the day. But so far, we are currently farming a Lulu top, so, you know, we take those. She picked Lulu into me, not sure why. I guess probably to never die, but the thing is, once I have Triforce, I'm pretty sure. Actually, no, it'd probably be pretty annoying to actually even kill her because of Polymorph Shield then self-ulting, so maybe I actually wouldn't be able to kill her. Who knows? Sorry. I am a little under the weather still, so which is actually not surprising at all, but also surprising I'm still sick, but it is what it is. Anyways, to shove this out, get a good recall off. Honestly, I might just get a Tiamat on my first back here. And I generally don't build Tiamat on Camille first item anymore, just because, well, if you're going Grassy Undying, you don't really care about Tiamat, you know, a Conquer, all that good jazz. But if I'm laning against a Lulu, who honestly will be hard to kill once she is level 6, which she is now, I think it's probably best I just go Tiamat, hard shove waves, and just try to roam around the map. Which I am going to do over here. I just need to finish my recon TP in. Spend this. Buy you. Right here. W. Nice, good job. So, if you're confused as to why I ulted Echo instead of Leona, well, I kind of missed my mouse on Echo, but the thing is, that was actually the right play just because I was actually able to knock Leona into my team right there. And that's just generally the most important thing right there. Honestly, it was a lot better that I did ult Echo there. Just because I knock a Leona into my team, that way everyone is able to DPS. And we just clearly ignore Echo because there's no real reason to actually focus him when he's so far away already. Like, he's already sitting on a turret. If I'm focusing him, well, if I get stunned in the turret by Leona as she's walking away, I die, right? And if, you know, that's pretty much it. And Leona's just the easiest target for everyone to hit, so that's pretty much what we want with. E TM at, not really going to focus her there. The only reason why I eat up like that is that way I can pass by the cannon minion and TM at it in midair, so I can pick up the gold, essentially. So she went, what are you building? Is she going AP? I'm pretty sure one of the AP items built off an amplifying tone, maybe. Well, not one of the support items, not an AP item. I'm not going to walk up to shove this wave yet because I think Echo should be topside after that fiasco. So I don't want to immediately jump on her yet. Auto Q, auto this once, TM at, auto. Ah, not enough attack speed, that's fine though. Anyways, we're going to move all the way over here, drop this ward, and we will ping for a gank in 50 seconds. He doesn't have to come at any given moment, but preferably in just 50 seconds. So Lulu's not here. We have our TM at. Let's just hard shove this lane out and just look to roam again. And Lulu should be a fast champion coming back to lane because she rushed tier 1 boots. And she gives herself movement speed. So, not really going to worry about that. Like I said, we are going to walk straight over here, see if we find Echo trying to do this. And if not, we are going to see if we can make a play happen with an E flash. Has F okay. Probably won't happen then, but we will see what does happen. He all of a sudden is walking up. All of a sudden, he just played really far back. It's kind of weird. 15 seconds. Is she shoving this wave out? Not entirely sure. She's kind of autoing, but she's also not. I just avoarded the hawk shot, but there's a control ward in this bush that I actually missed the entirety of. All right, that's fine. Just back the lane over here. See this guy over here. That's fine. That's why hawk shot actually didn't reveal me, because I was actually already sitting on a ward. Nice. Not bad. Good thing I actually caught that, right? Because if I didn't catch the ward, next time I walk back down there, it's gonna suck. Let's be real here. Lost chapter. So she's actually going AP. Huh. Alright, Lulu. If that's what you're really about. Let's see. Does she exhaust? Yes, she does. She flashes. Has to flash away, unfortunately. Echo is right there. Graves does do the Drake. Does get ulted, unfortunately. Braum with the Guardian Shield, the W. Senna ulting in. They should just be able to walk out. Might still kill one more auto. Nice job. Lulu is TPing down. Don't know where she is, but I am currently walking down. Lulu is all the way down here, pinging my team to be careful of the Lulu coming in. Braum, just please back off. You are greeting way too much. Spam pinging what is happening. And the thing is, Lulu does have her ultimate, which is really the only issue. Yep. I'm actually going to go past them. Go into their backline carry. Press the R key. You're dead, love. Sorry. Auto Q2. And one more auto for the road. Nice! Very good job. So yeah, I just stunned these two over here who are basically Lulu and Ash, who are the primary DPS in that fight. Yeah, I mean, Leona's was somehow still able to 1v2, but I mean, she killed Braum, but she didn't kill Graves. Lulu had the flash to actually pick up that kill, so that actually works out really good for us. And not to mention, Graves actually stole that Drake, which is actually really huge, because we were healing 2.5% of our missing health every 5 seconds in that fight as well. So really good stuff from my team there, but just exceptional job on our Graves. They actually played that really well. Braum did too. Sadly, he didn't exhaust. If he did exhaust, they probably wouldn't have died at all, but it's all good. Going in. Relax. Nice damage. And now we walk back in the lane as the better top laner. Was down. Okay. Water is good. But really good stuff to actually walk down. Because imagine if I don't walk down at all. We don't kill Ash. We don't kill Lulu. And Leona on top of that. So really good stuff that I walked down. She went Hex at GOP. Interesting. Q2. There's half her HP. She just did all that into my shield. Yeah, you're not going to have a good time anymore, Lulu. I'll tell you that right now. So we don't know the combo I just did there. It's literally ETM at. And that's literally it. ETM at the same time. I Q a minion, obviously, prep on my Q. E as I'm flying in towards her, press TM at because you can use your TM at during your E key and your W key as well, like this, which allows you to auto attack still, apparently, which I don't believe. But that's what people say. And then Q2 on our way out, we press our W key to, you know, get some healing if she does return trades on us, but also more importantly to slow her down, that way she can't get that much of a return trade on us. Anyways, we are going to drop this ward over here. Sees we use control ward. I shall be taking that from you, Lulu. And she's practically fully healed off all her crafting pots. Alright, that's really good. See what I mean? Like, generally, you want to just get one good trade that just completely cooks her corrupting pots. Do have my ult right here, if he does want to come back topside. Nice job. I just want my team to be slightly careful because I do have TP in 25. So I don't want them to do anything stupid until my TP is actually, like, genuinely back up. They just shouldn't auto-attack if we're being real. Unless, well, I guess Senna gets increased movement speed. But yeah, if only one of them dies, it's actually perfectly fine. Can dive. Wow, he actually still died. That's so sad. Very, very sad. Anyways, he should just get first turret off this. Auto-Q. I could TP as well, but honestly, there's no real reason to. We do get first tower here. I actually want to be in the vicinity of this, by the way, because it gives me Triforce on my back. Wait, I need this. Nice. Now I have Triforce on my back, which is the most important thing. And if a fight does happen to break out, I can TP literally right here. Onto their backline, which is the plan if they do greed. Looks like they are not greeting though, which is really good. And I think Echo's walking, yep, right back here. Not gonna TP because obviously the guy has his R key. That'd be very stupid of me. But we will actually run straight mid lane, go for an E flash play, and just hitting my ult on this Lucian. I think he got a kill recently. I'm hoping he did because that means he's actually worth gold. I got some damage off. I like that. I like the spice in your eyes. And we're just gonna sit really far back. Bait. just look juicy. That's all you gotta do. I find that really funny that she's just literally holding a melee minion up to her name, dude. It's actually, I find that hilarious. And let's just go topside and, like, I guess 100-0 this Lulu. Why do you have this? I thought you died. Did she get 3 assists? I think maybe she got 3 assists done. Another control ward. Don't mind if I do. I wonder who's placing that. It might be Lucian who's actually placing that. And Lulu's obviously not going to bother walking up when her turret is down because she walks up at pretty much right here. I can just run her down 100-0 her. And just render her useless. So it makes sense that she's not here. Thing is she here already? She is. Might still kill one more E? Nice job. Really good stuff right there. Lulu's already down there because she doesn't have TP for Drake. So she's just trying to get into position. Yeah, you're just dead. Sadly, you're just dead. I thought it was going to be pretty obvious that Echo was going to move around. I should have pinged, but that's my bad. Lulu should have to come topside here. Like, I'm literally just going to get objective. If not, Echo might move here too to actually stop me and just pick up a shutdown. Here's Lulu. Lulu, no TP. She's all the way up here, and I have TP. We want to look for this fight here, guys. I'm going to Rika here, by the way, and pick up Merc Chest because they have a shit ton of CC for no reason. I'm not going to TP there because that's just a bad TP. If this is a pick, though, it's a really good pick. Nice. Should be a kill. TP in. We see Echo. Merc Chest here. Wait, Lulu's TP is actually up. What? Bye-bye! Wait, her TP was actually up, and I just didn't know that. Oh, might be. TP shorter. Anyways, come over here, guys. It's a free Drake. I still have my R key for the Echo, which is really good. And obviously, you know, we go for the E-Flash play on top of the Ash to not make my TP useless. I'm pretty sure she completely... I think she straight up ulted me, though, which kind of sucks. Or ulted my Graves, one of the two. Either way, either or. It always sucks. I'm gonna say he picks up turret mid lane. Echo is doing his thing down here. Echo is getting fed, which is maybe the unfortunate thing, but he doesn't really matter too much. And if I do find Lucian, I should be able to kill. I don't have Tabby though. The only reason I wouldn't kill is if he has Ignite. And I just pressing my. What are you. Senna, what was that ult, man? What was that? Shot it 10 years late. That's so unfortunate. I knew he was going to dash over the wall, but I didn't know if someone else was going to come actually help me, so I didn't bother ulting. But then I saw Cassiopeia, so I sort of ulted immediately, but I was obviously really slow on that. To be fair, though, my setup Come on, man. Your one job is to look at the map and press your R key on time. And she didn't press it on time that time, sadly. Like, she literally pressed it when I was already dead. It was pretty sad. But yeah, the only way Lucian can realistically kill me is if he has Ignite. To actually do damage to shred through me. Hopefully you have dash. Yeah, I don't know. Like, it was pretty obvious that they were following him the entire time. But that was just really bad for no reason. Like, exceptionally bad. I'm so surprised he just stood there, though. That's kind of weird. I guess he saw me moving at half HP, right? Oh! I like this. Press the R key just in case. And just like that, she's dead. Cassio, why are you pinging me? You have a crush on me? I think she has a crush on me, guys. You got a crush on me? Ooh. But anyways, I guess I could quote unquote talk about the matchup. Lulu top is something you generally never see, but if you are against a support in top lane, Camille players always carry. Ah. But if you are against a support in top lane, your only role is to literally outperform them. That's all you gotta do. And another thing that I generally do a lot, but sometimes I have these games where I am just super focused. Nice, we just got our ultimate for free, that's so huge. And she has polymorph, which is the issue, but we just got her R, which is nice. They shut down Echo 2, which is amazing. We're going to E out of here, I don't want to stick around. Anyway, I'm actually going to move down here so we can work on this turret here. My team needs to be more apparent of these roams though, for sure. I'm going to walk back here, pick up this ward. And then come down here and yoink their gold. Because I don't want to be around there. And just because, honestly, I'm very close to Ravenous Hydra, that I do want to be yoinking gold at this point. But yeah, your only job is literally to just try your hardest to outperform a support. That's literally it if you are against it. Because generally the supports will try to roam. Or just, you know, do their support things and try to just, you know, carry their team via shielding and all that good stuff. And that's what Lulu's going to try to do. And that's why she has Boots of Swiftness out of all boots. Because, you know, she's a support. She's trying to roam around, do all that good stuff. I hope to God you're not alone, man. Because if you are sitting there by yourself, it's not a good look, Lucian. Not at all. Okay, that's what I thought, buddy. It most certainly wouldn't have been a good look for you, I will say that. Thing is, we don't see anyone else around here. So it's either they're giving that, and they're coming to form at me, or they're hovering, and we just have zero vision. Either way, I don't really want to jump on Lucian without having any vision. Like, see how he's walking up like that? That's so weird. Because I can straight up 100-0 him. He's walking up, like, without a care in the world. So that kind of tells you that there's someone shadowing him. Like, see, right now, I don't see Echo. I see everyone but Echo right here. So I have to play it safe. Because I don't know where Echo is, which is the issue. So he might have been sitting on the turret. Ping, I have gold I want to spend. Look at the mini-map more. Be wary of their roams. / ganks. By you. Double control ward. And keep moving. I want to be bot lane. That's for sure. I don't want to TP with Lulu again, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure I want to be here before anything happens. Which is what she's going to do. But the thing is, there's no reason for me to really be topside at this point. Just because this wave is already pushing out. That's one. And two, like, I'm already in base. I might as well walk straight to drag since it's already coming up. Graves is... I can pick this guy. I 100% firmly believe this guy is greeting. And they're actually sending everyone over here. You gotta leave. I got you. You want a W to me at all, man? Like, W to me? Like, I'm so confused. Why didn't you just W to me, man? He just threw. I literally eat over the wall so he can W to me. That's so awkward, man. Smite steal? Nah, just leave. Taking 10,000 damage, dude. Man, that really sucks. But I'm like just hard through. I'm so confused. Not sure what that positioning was. If it's a pick, it's a pick. But if it's not, like, I don't know what my team is doing. That's some big damage, though. Good job, Senna. Bye-bye. All right. This works out. Good job, team. Why are you fast? Good job, team! Man, that was really scary. I don't know, they did Drake so fast. Like, I mean, if I walk up, it's not gonna do anything. You know, Echo can still press Smite even if I do stun him. Yes, he can press Smite during CC. So it's not like it mattered. DPS. They don't really need me. I don't think they do anyways. We're gonna take a free turret here. Cassiopeia should be more than enough DPS. Q2, and I'm gonna start moving, and we're actually gonna drop a control ward here so I can find Echo. Echo actually died without pressing R, by the way. Like, I'm not sure why he greeted, but he did. But yeah, like I said, they didn't need me, so I was able to take a free turret for my team. Then I can walk back over here and, you know, help them out. Do I move my control ward is the question. Yes, I do, because they're gonna try yoinking it. Yeah, right over there. So I'm gonna place it that way. Hopefully I can just deny them 30 gold for free. Oh, alright, you got it, love. Back here, we are gonna go to Death's Dance because it is a awesome item, and we are gonna pick up the Aegis of Legion just because it's better that I am tank here at this point, because I straight up take a lot of damage from Lucian and Ashe, sadly. But they do have a ton of CC, so I did have to go Merc Treads. Is Lu following? No, it's Echo. I guess they're tilted if Echo is just starting to take farm like that. But yeah, whenever the enemy team, this man went double Black Cleaver. What? He has 800 HP, 80 AD, and 40% CDR instantly. So he's doing it for the raw stats alone and not for the stacks. Okay. I guess he's tanky? He has 2500 HP. I feel like he'd be better off with Death's Dance, though. Well, he should go with Death's Dance next, which I think he is doing. But anyways, as I was saying, whenever a Drake is down, like let's say you were fighting for a Drake, but then the enemy team happens to take it, generally you don't look to fight because there's nothing to fight over, like the objective was dead. But I'm not entirely sure what happened. Yo, relax. For top, for whatever godforsaken reason. But yeah, as I was saying, generally you don't look to fight, but I'm not sure what happened there, but it ended up being a good fight for us, so we take those. This guy does dash. You can press your R, you can interrupt Lucian R, by the way, which is actually pretty darn cool if I do say so myself. Because Lucian's R is a channel. So just like that, we pick up another kill. I don't really want to E just so I can get this wave in case they have to TP, but it's fine. I think Cassiopeia should be here. I think it should be 1-1-3, but I guess their team has way too much hard engage, so it's just not worth it. And I do have TP if need be, I just gotta be wary. They might try to set up a TP play. I mean, a play like this. I still don't have the TP. Nothing's really happening for me. It's just a fight that my team's winning. I'm not gonna bother TPing right now. Gray is flashing over the wall. They still don't need me. Just focus on this right now. Pay attention to my team. They are still currently winning the fight. Not bad. Like I said, just save my TP. Like, knowing when you should and shouldn't TP is also a really important thing. Because obviously, imagine I TP there. We take this and then, like, obviously I don't shove the wave out. Or we don't take this right afterwards, you know? So very important that I don't TP and we are able to get two objectives off of this. Well, that's not very good, guys. I'm perma-slowed. Oh my god, Ash, you actually do damage. I also messed up my E, not gonna lie. Let's just back off unless that's 10,000 damage coming through. Nice, actually. Good, Brahmi. We should actually win the game off this. Lifesteal back up. Q2 do half her HP. She's trying to stall, but it's not gonna happen, love. Like I said, simply outperform the support you are playing against top lane. Yeah, when my E was on CD and then Ash was already 10,000 feet away, I knew I wasn't gonna be able to hit my E on that chick. What's my team doing? Focusing that for what reason? So I'd rather just not jump on them until I have my R key. If my team wants to go for it, sure, but I'm thinking that I'm not gonna do anything. I'm thinking that I'm thinking to back off, which generally insinuates that I'm gonna back off. Press R to dodge the stun. This guy's gonna try R-ing back. It's not gonna work out. Wait, save me, save me! Let's go! Alright, GJ played, like, comment, and subscribe to see you guys next video. Peace! That was honestly a good game.